the hydraulic pump, system relief, circuit relief, or the directional control valve is not the reason for slow cylinder operation, you should also check for internal leakage around the piston seals inside the cylinder. Piston seal leakage is not acceptable to most manufacturers. Even a minor amount of leakage will reduce the operating speed and slow down the extension and retraction time of the cylinder rod. Once the technician has determined the hydraulic pump, spool valve, and relief valves are not at fault, cylinder seals can be tested for leakage using system pressure or a hand pump. Extend or retract the piston in the cylinder to be tested. Lower the mechanism to the ground. Shut down the engine and neutralize the hydraulics. Put on an approved face shield and gloves to protect you from hot oil. Remove the hose from the end of the cylinder where the piston is resting. Place the hose in a bucket to collect the oil. Then, pressurize the cylinder for 20 seconds at maximum governed RPM and watch to see if oil is leaking past the piston seals and into the bucket. Excessive leakage will slow down the response time and reduce the power of the cylinder. Abrasion scratches clearly indicate a lack of maintenance. Dirt and wear metals easily damage cylinder walls and piston seals. Piston seals harden with age and heat. Seals that have hardened from heat are not elastic and will not seal against hydraulic oil pressure. Additionally, as they harden, they also easily crack. Cracked seals provide a leaking surface for high pressure oil, thus reducing the cylinder's power and response time. Before removing a cylinder from the machine, check to see if the retainer is threaded. If so, loosen the retainer by letting the machine stop the cylinder from turning. To prevent scratching the piston's metal sealing surface, be sure to round the corners of any service tool you use when removing or installing seals. There are many types of seals, packings, and wipers used on cylinders. Be sure to check with each manufacturer for replacement parts and correct installation procedures. Some manufacturers use O-ring seals and backup rings next to the O-ring to prevent the O-ring from rolling. Carefully examine the backup rings, as some have a concave surface to fit the O-ring. Be careful when installing the piston into the cylinder bore to prevent the new seals from rolling, folding, cutting, or tearing. When installing lip seals on pumps and motors, be sure the lip of the seal faces inward toward the pressure side. Otherwise, the pressurized oil will leak under the lip. Always contact the manufacturer for correct replacement parts. Will-fit seals and hoses may fit, but may not be compatible with hydraulic oil. There is a common myth that needs to be clarified about leaking cylinder seals. The general belief is that a load will settle if the cylinder piston seals leak. As discussed earlier, even if the piston seals are removed, a load will not settle. To illustrate this point, let's use an excavator with a heavy boom and dipper arm. Before disassembling, all hydraulic pressure trapped in the hydraulic system is neutralized. The hoses are loosened and removed. The oil is carefully caught in a container. The fitting is redirected to drain the oil into the container. The cylinder rod seal retainer is loosened. The rod pin is removed. The cylinder rod seal retainer and piston assembly are removed. The piston ring seals are removed. The piston and rod assembly are reinstalled in the cylinder without piston seals. The cylinder rod is pinned and the hoses are connected. Next, the engine is started and the boom's directional control valve is held in the lift position to fill the cylinder with oil. Oil passes by the piston and purges the air on the retraction side of the piston. This removes all air. The engine is shut down. Caps are put on the cylinder hose fittings and the jack is removed. 4 hours later, the boom, without piston seals, is still in the air. Since the larger volume of oil below the piston cannot fit into the smaller volume above the piston cannot move in the cylinder.